It is contraindicated. You could not use Paxlovid with those four medications for epilepsy. Paxlovid is a new medication for treatment of COVID-19, and it does have a lot of interactions with the anti-seizure medication that you might be taking. So you really need to know and be aware of all of these interactions before deciding if this medicine is for you. As an epilepsy doctor myself, I get lots of questions about if my patient who got COVID-19 and have epilepsy can take Paxlovid, and what are the potential interactions and things we need to worry about. And thanks to the American Epilepsy Society for lots of information and resources on this matter. Paxlovid was approved in December 22nd, 2021, and it was approved for 12 years and older who had mild to moderate COVID-19 infection, and it is a medicine that stops viral replication, so it needs to be given as soon as possible to stop the virus from getting more and more copies. That is why you need to start the medicine as soon as possible, and you need those informations right away when you are making decisions if you can take this medicine or not. Paxlovid is a medication which is a combination of nirmatrelvir, which is the active ingredient, and this medicine is very effective against the virus. However, the liver processes this medication very quickly and clears it out very, very quickly. So we need to keep this medicine staying in the blood for longer. And to do that, we have a combination of ritonavir, which is blocking the cytochrome P450 enzyme that processes the first ingredient in the liver and makes it last longer in the blood. And here comes the problem, because lots of medications, including anti-seizure medication, are being processed by this cytochrome P450 enzyme group, and that makes lots of drug-drug interactions. There are four interactions to be worried about. First group of interactions are the extreme enzyme inducers, which makes the liver process this Paxlovid medication very quickly. And those medications include carbamazepine, phenobarbital, phenytoin, and primidone. And if you are taking Paxlovid with those medications, Paxlovid levels will be dropping very quickly, and the body will not have enough medicine to fight the virus, and that will render the Paxlovid ineffective, and worse, it can cause viral resistance. So we're basically vaccinating COVID-19 against the Paxlovid medication. So it is contraindicated. You could not use Paxlovid with those four medications for epilepsy. And the second group of interaction with another group of medication that can be weak inducers of the cytochrome P450 enzymes, including cenobamate, islicarbazepine, oxcarbazepine, rufinamide, and topiramate. Those medications can potentially decrease the levels of Paxlovid and makes it a little bit less effective against COVID-19. So if you're taking those medications, you can still take Paxlovid, but it might not work as well. So you should use it with caution with those medications. And the third group of interactions, the medications that themselves get affected by the Paxlovid inhibition of the liver enzymes, and those medications are being processed also by the liver enzyme that being blocked by the Paxlovid ingredients. And those medications include cannabidiol, Epidiolex, carbamazepine, clonazepam, clobazam, diazepam, ethosuximide, everolimus, felbamate, lacosamide, midazolam, oxcarbazepine, perampanel, stiropentol, tiagabine, and zunisamide. That's it. So most of the anti-seizure medications. So because Paxlovid stops the liver enzyme from processing these medications, it will make the levels of those medications higher in the blood, and that can lead into toxicity and lots of more side effects from those medications, and in some cases, it can be life-threatening. So, if you decide to use Paxlovid with your doctor with those group of medications, it can be given, but we should very closely monitor the blood levels of those medications and watch for any toxicity and side effects. So, we should exercise extreme caution when we're using this medicine. And it is important to note that the effect of Paxlovid on the liver enzyme and those interactions lasts beyond the 5-day treatment course, because it will irreversibly inhibit the liver enzymes, and it can can last for a little longer than that, so you should watch for that even after stopping and finishing the Paxlovid course. And the fourth interaction will be with lamotrigine. So lamotrigine has a unique interaction because it is processed by a subtype of the liver enzymes, and Paxlovid actually induces that subtype of enzymes, the glucuronation, and it makes it less active and makes lamotrigine levels lower in the blood. So we should check lamotrigine levels in the blood very carefully when we are doing treatment with Paxlovid. There are a few anti-seizure medications that have no interaction with the liver enzymes and they do not get processed significantly by the liver. And if you are on those medications, you will be lucky, such as levetiracetam or Keppra. And you might ask yourself, what should I do if I have COVID-19 and I need treatment and I am taking one of those medications that we mentioned above that we could not take? So the recommendations here will be to take another medication for COVID-19. And luckily we have two now, including molnupiravir, which is an oral medication, and IV therapy such as remdesivir. And we should know that those medications do not interact with the liver enzyme, and so they do not interact with the anti-seizure medications. However, those medications can have some more side effects, and sometimes they are less available, especially the IV medication. You need to be in the hospital or have more complicated administration. And if you have epilepsy, I'm sure that you have more questions about what causes epilepsy, how to treat it, and many other questions regarding the diagnosis of epilepsy. And to answer all of these questions, I have this video for you to answer all of your questions. And stay healthy, and see you in the next one. Salam.